Hello, this is Bern, and on today's episode, I'm going to share with you how to know if he is actually the one. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your greatlifetv.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious, heart-centered, and successful women how you can create the relationship of your dreams and attract the kind of quality man you want into your life with no need for gimmicks or manipulation, and as a result of stepping in the most alive and the most feminine version of you. Today is part 4 of 5, and on today's episode, I'm gonna be sharing with you how to know if he's the one. We've talked about hidden barriers, we've talked about how to select a guy, how to know the qualities you're looking for in a man. We've talked about how to step into attracting that human being. And today I'm gonna share with you, if you found a guy, let's say you're connecting with him, he's your boyfriend, things are getting serious, and you want to know if he is the one, here's 8 principles that I would love for you to step into with a bonus one. So it's really 9, but I'm gonna say 8 right now. The first principle is that there is more than one the one. Let me clarify what this means. There isn't just one man out of 3.5 billion humans on this planet that could potentially be your lifelong lover and best friend. There are multiple men. So the man that you choose as the one is the one you choose as the one. Does that make sense? I don't buy into, well, this is the most perfect out of everyone in humanity. You'll never know if it's the most perfect, but you're gonna do everything you can, and he's gonna do everything he can to make this worthwhile and an incredible journey for both. So as long as you understand that principle, then you are going to relax a little bit more and not feel like, well, maybe there's someone even better than him. If this guy is great, make him the one. If he's an amazing guy that's offering you what you want, then instead of questioning whether there might be someone even more perfect, just give him the benefit of the doubt and do what you have to do to create that meaningful relationship. Number 2, I want you to understand that on every successful relationship out there, the most successful relationships out there, and I'm talking about relationships that last 20 years, 30 years, 40 years, 50 years, there, statistically speaking, scientifically speaking, will be at least 10 irreconcilable differences. Irreconcilable differences. My Spanish English here. So here's what I mean. There's going to be areas of connection where you don't see eye to eye. There's going to be things where you will never, it's like black and white, purple and green, like it just won't be what you expect it to be. You want to make sure that those differences that are inevitable are some that you can live with. That's all. Don't expect for the guy to be exactly the guy you want. I've had women who tell me, describe the guy they want to the T, where there's no room for difference or spontaneity, and the differences will make the relationship strong so long as they're not in vital, fundamental things that you need in order to move forward. Number 3, you know he's the one when you feel mostly encouraged in his presence, where you feel like you, the best version of you, can come forth without much trouble, where you can feel at home, where you can feel seen, where you can feel heard, when you feel understood. If you connect with someone who fundamentally has this type of friendship with you, where you feel lifted up, you feel like you have more strength versus less strength as a result of the connection, that's a good sign that he could be the one. Number 4, he chooses to see the best in you. He's not oblivious to the fact that there's shit that you want to change or that you need to change. So one extreme of this would be a guy who blindly falls in love with you and thinks that your faults are cute. So that's one extreme. Another one would be a guy who understands that you're a human being, you have faults, he has faults, and you're doing the best you can to change them. So long as you're growing in your life, then he chooses to focus on the things that are your greatest assets versus remind you of your shortcomings. Mostly he sees the greatness versus the smallness in you. Number 5, he is a guy that you share important common values with, such as family values. And it doesn't mean that both of you need to want a family. Maybe both of you don't want a family, but that's a shared common value. If you want a family, he doesn't. That's a big clusterfuck area of potential challenge, or imminent challenge, not potential. What type of education do you want to give to your children? What type of spiritual values do you share or not share? What kind of work do you do in the world? How do you share with people around you? What kind of respect do you value or not value? Those things are fundamentally important. And if you don't share enough common values with them, the challenge is, typically, if you find a guy that you find super strong chemistry with, but values are not the same, it will not last. How do I know? I mean, maybe after helping a few thousand women get what they want and see when women don't get what they want, why it is, one of the strong reasons why you won't get what you want is if you don't share enough common values to make the inevitable difficulty and hardship and sacrifice that you'll have to step into worth your while. Number six, not only do you share common values, but you share a similar vision of what life is. If you're someone who enjoys the outdoors every single day of your life, and he's someone who enjoys Netflix and he hates the outdoors, well, that's a gigantic difference in vision of life. If you want seven children, he wants no children. That's a difference in vision of life. If you see yourself maybe volunteering and traveling the world when you retire, and he sees himself never retiring and always being chained to a desk, that's a difference in vision of life. It doesn't mean it can't work. It just means that the more differences there are in terms of your end goal, the type of life you want to live, your lifestyle, the more challenging it will be for him to be the one that you choose and continue choosing. Number seven, you can talk about difficult things. He's the kind of guy who doesn't just run away every time there's a problem, or who denies that things are happening, or who puts his own challenges back to you as if they're your problems. He's a guy who has the intensity and the clarity and the groundedness to be able, and the testicular fortitude to be able to talk to you about difficult things without running away, without making it your fault. That is such a fundamental trait that you need in the one. Why? Because imagine 50 years of being with someone and the number of difficult challenges and conversations and situations and just life things that show up without being able to have a clear line of communication, you will feel like you're trapped. You'll feel in prison. And that's the worst type of feeling if you're with someone. Number eight, he is willingly moving things forward. And I'm talking about right now a situation where you're not married yet and you're dating and then you're engaged and then you're getting married. The last thing you want for the one is the one that you have to babysit through the process of becoming a man and going through emotional puberty and getting ready and getting excited, almost like doing you the favor of getting married to you. If a guy isn't willingly moving things forward, everyone can have their own fears and insecurities and bullshit, right? Everyone can get stuck at times. But if he's fundamentally getting stuck and you're the one moving things forward, you're the one who wants this more than he does, it ain't gonna work. So make sure that for you to choose him as the one, he's choosing you as the one as well. The last one, the bonus one that I'll share with you is, and I've shared this in every single one of these videos, and I have to share it right now in case you haven't watched the other ones or you choose not to watch them. Time. You know he's the one through time. It's easy to see someone, feel like you fall in love, even though you're falling in lust, feel like your karmic connection is through the roof and that you know each other for 17 lifetimes. But to actually make it work, you need on the ground, getting the hands in the mud and doing life together. You know he's the one when he sustainably, consistently shows up in a way that shows you he has what it takes to take it all the way. If you find this is helpful, meaningful to you in some way, I'm gonna ask you to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, subscribe to my channel and click the little bell if you wanna be notified of new episodes, including the last one of this series that's coming up soon. And third and most important of all, if you want to take these learnings further, I've created a masterclass for you. It's 40 minutes long and it's free. All you have to do is go to the first link in the description of this video, click on it, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately redirected to that masterclass that's free. If you want to work with me, if you want me to help you get what you want without going through the trial and error of things, maybe the way you are right now, then second link in the description of this video will allow you to apply to work with me. Thank you so much for connecting, for opening your hearts, and I challenge you to live a full and a very conscious life.